G'day everyone, Gavin Topp here from Fight Like a Pro. I want to introduce you to one of our fighters, Drew Krupp, absolute champion. He's actually fighting by the name of the Firecracker. And mate, when we first spoke, you said that you'd been driving past our sign for 2 years.
Yeah.
What made you say, all right, now's the right time?
I guess I kept bumping into people in the street that had done it. And they all said the same thing. It was a major turning point of their life. And I even met a guy who owns 15 gyms.
Yeah.
And then he said to me that that was the single moment, the single thing he did. That was only 10 weeks long. It was the toughest. But he considers that a major turning point for his life. But he was already a success.
Yeah.
You know, what other people would think was a success. So I went, wow. And I'd already gone past your sign. And I saw that in the biggest, you know, 24 men. And I kind of worked out that they fight each other, and I thought, what a brilliant idea to test yourself against normal guys.
Yeah.
And I'm here in the fifth week, and I feel like we're all the same.
Yeah.
You know, and it just depends on how hard you work.
Yeah.
But in effect, we're all the same people, and I'm getting real good feelings from the other guys.
When you started, what did you want to achieve?
Well, I've got a young family, and you never know. You just never know what will happen.
Yeah.
Okay, I had a big face accident when I was racing cars, and my face is covered in plates here, and I don't even know whether I've always wanted to know for about 5 years now how I'd hold up if I had to defend my family.
Yeah.
And this is probably the only test I could give it.
Yeah.
Really, you don't want to. I don't. You know.
Yeah.
Tell me another way that I could test my face.
Yeah.
And we've been doing it lightly with the other guys. Yeah. I'm in a controlled environment here. I feel like I'm on top of that mentally now.
Yeah.
And now I've just got some tools in the belt. Not that I ever want to. No one wants to be in fights. No smart guy wants to be in a fight. But that, you know, we were cavemen not long ago, right?
Yeah.
That's why I always say that. And I think that you know, you have to stand up for yourself now and then, just to prove your point. This is what I believe in. And I feel that every day that we do this, I feel a bit better towards that. And that goes for business too.
Yeah.
You know, you can have people getting one over you in business.
Okay.
And it just feels like I've got a few more things under me to go, no, mate, this is what I believe in.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and it's a subliminal power.
Yeah.
You know.
Terrific.
So, yeah. And I felt that you had it. And I was like, oh, you know, here's the guy that I keep driving past his sign. And look, and I thought, yeah, I can feel that.
Yeah.
I felt it from the other guy that owned all the gyms. So
that's
just one of the reasons I'm here. There's plenty more. But
Well, he mentioned that we were in boxing lolly. Well, last night we sparred. You didn't go light. That was an awesome effort. You guys were going toe to toe. That you were using the technique that we've taught you. And mate, it was hard. Was it hard or did it just look hard?
It was really hard, but it didn't hurt.
Yeah.
That's the thing.
Yeah.
I guess we're just getting fitter.
Yeah.
It's more like sport.
The
biggest hits hit you, but it doesn't feel like it hurts. It's more like an adrenaline. You want to congratulate the guy that hits you.
Yeah.
And he wants to congratulate you. It's more like, you hit me so good. Well done, mate. And, you know.
Is this bloke awesome or what?
No, I feel really good.
So I suppose I just want to say to everybody, Firecracker, he's going around on the 22nd of November at Jupiter's Casino. So all his friends and family are going to be there. So I just encourage you, come along and support him, and we're going to let the firecrackers off. Over and out.
I'm going to win too.